hero because we actually know them, but let's just keep this out of the Mario rat now. May the best team win. Whoever deserves to qualify to the AGC CSGO Winter Open Tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, we're on.
Now let the round begin. It's gonna be Ground Zero here pushing towards that connector really quickly. Virus just wants to grab that information needed. And we are listening to Spy for some reason here. It's gonna be Virus giving you really good information. Four team Ground Zero here. They know it's gonna be a B push and it's gonna be Latal charging towards that B side really quickly. Rookie is gonna get the first, Fools is gonna get the second, and Hamad is gonna get the third. It's down to a 3v4 situation. Nice shot there by Spy in a very crucial position. Spy goes for the second, and he's gonna go for the third. Meanwhile, he's gonna go for the third as well. Spy in an unbelievable position. Who does not check that spot?
I mean, did you see that thing when he was just like trying to dig down the floor, just like looking down at the floor, probably trying to, you know, dodge the bullets all around his face. That was a nice play by Spy.
There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, you decide and start betting from now who is going to win this map, because it's really important for both teams. And we're going to see a B charge push here. Nice molly there by Blue, but the Tech Nines are never going to stop. And 4 by Spy gets a double kill. Really nice ranges in with a third one more time. Spy with a USP in hand. He is going to die. I'm coughing. I cannot scream anymore. And Rookie is going to finish things off eventually with their USP.
Okay, I'd love to say God Spy. You know, let's say God Spy because this is his name. Like, this guy is—he's like he got the energy now. Let's go. This is gonna be amazing. This is gonna be an amazing game. Looks good so far.
It does look good so far, actually. 2-0 for C5. You know, the easy round here for Ground Zero. And Tyrex is just heading with his team towards that B side one more time. Meanwhile, the bomb trying to faking it towards that A. I mean, all they need from this round is the bomb plant. And Nico is gonna get the first, drops the second one real quickly. He's gonna fail to do that actually, but he's gonna rush in and die from that P2000. And it's gonna be Blue with that USP, just crushing everything in their way.
Oh, but the bomb is slipping away on long.
And I think Ground Zero, they have a lead already, and unfortunately he's going to be able to plant that bomb, but that's the whole goal of the round.
Absolutely, they needed the money. Next round they're going to have an op, most probably. Alvar is going to buy an op. This is how it looks like. Probably without a helmet though. But that was the whole plan indeed. They just did a suicidal of 4 people, actually managed to get a kill on Nico, and got the bomb planted in the A side. Well played,
C5. A really important round for C5 here. They managed to get what they really wanted. Now they can go with a full buy and a full utility here, and this round explains it all, probably.
Here's the op in Alvar, just like I called it. He proved himself to be a good opper, and here he is playing the op. Let's see what he can do with that op.
He's actually going to force himself to go towards that monster area. Cool. Meanwhile, C5 basically going to control mid. That's what they're going to do. But Oliver is going to switch decisions. And we're going to see Cool just getting down Rookie here towards that mid area. Virus from the connector trying to shoot someone. I mean, Spy one more time with the aggressiveness. He's going to get a double kill. Cool almost down, but no, he's down to 57 HP only. And it is going to be a 2v3 situation here. Blue and Nico are the two men who can actually do this, but C5, they are back on track. They have one man on that A side and one man towards that B side. Now, the rotations here are just too low, maybe, for Ground Zero. I mean, you need a lot of time to go from B to A, but from A to B, you can just go really fast.
Really fast, yeah. And look at the weapon that Cuff is holding. It's the HJ553. You don't see a lot of people actually playing that weapon. And people think this is a Call of Duty style, but actually it's a very difficult weapon to play with. And it's actually strange to see a CSGO player.
About to happen. It's gonna wait and wait patiently, and there it is. The information has been given. They are charging towards that A site really quickly. They have no clue where Blue is. He's gonna get spotted and gets headshotted immediately. And look at Nico, it's a 1v2, he's down to 9 HP only, trying to deny that bomb plant, but it's not gonna work. 15 seconds on the clock, and that sniper shot almost hit Nico. It's gonna be horrible for him. We need to see Cool here, just waiting patiently behind that truck. And his mate is just gonna look towards that A long side, and look at Nico. It's a really good weapon to play, actually, in Overpass. You know, you have a lot of wide angles, a lot of far angles to do with. This is going to be amazing. 5 with a really nice round here, played strategically. I think Ground Zero had the right to push. I mean, they did not waste too much money on buying this round. They just went with whatever weapons they had since the last couple of rounds. So I think their economy is still good. As you can buy, is destroying everyone right now with the top fragging from both sides of the teams. We're gonna see full buy from both teams one more time. We're gonna see Rookie with AWP. A double op setup ice on Overpass is just huge.
A double op setup actually is really good because, you know, also in Overpass you got a lot of distance.
But look at this ice, look at this. We're gonna see Nico trying to go for that peak and really nice and boost here by Spy. And you don't want to give that weapon to Spy. I mean, he already has sick aim, and imagine him holding this. It's gonna be phenomenal.
This
we're gonna see Rookie playing really close to where's that connector area here. Rookie just waiting for someone, and look at this. Rookie with that flick shot, how could you not hear that Cool? And Rookie with a second almost there. He's gonna adjust it and kill him. Nice shots by Rookie there. And down to 4v2. Ladies and gentlemen, Fools and Oliver is just and standing here. Virus with just a 5-7 in hand, but trust me, that 5-7 is deadly in the hands of the right people. Nice way here to see, and look at Nico just roaming around the AWP, and it's all on Fools. The last guy, the last guy standing. Yeah, he's gonna go from that toilets area. Meanwhile, Blue is still on that B site, and Fools is just slowly going towards that A site.
Yeah, this is funny. This is like, you know, watching Tom and Jerry. They're both trying to catch each other.
That was the laugh that you were talking about earlier. We need to see right now the bomb is heading towards that A long area. He's gonna spot that first. Tries to spray him down. It's not gonna work. He's gonna get the kill eventually. 20 seconds on the clock, and look at the CTs, they are charging towards that site really, really fast. The bomb is planted on the other side of the map. He doesn't have it for long, he just planted it for the connector, and hopefully Wolves is going to be able to clutch this round, but it seems to be impossible though. Have 3 people alive, one could defuse, and there it is, Blue is going to be able to take him out.
Probably what he was trying to do is like was trying to pre-fire the stairs to be lucky and get a headshot, but in a 1v3 situation, if you really want to win, you shouldn't really expose yourself until you actually hear the bomb text or somebody actually forces his way to you. He just gave his position immediately. I mean, Nico tried to smoke him off, Blue just sprayed him off. It wasn't like a round that he wanted to win.
Probably that's it, and we're gonna see a 4-1 lead here by Team GZ. And again, Ice, this is not a T-sided or a CT-sided map, it's equally balanced depending on how the teamwork works. And look at Rookie, just an amazing flick shot there towards Cool, one of the best players on C5, and Nico just waiting patiently. The double AWP setup is just working fine, and Rookie with another kill, Virus spraying with the M4, and Rookie just from the toilet spots another guy. Nice flick shot by Rookie, and this is gonna be an easy round for Ground Zero.
Yes,
one more time.
You gotta love the aggression. You know, this is the beauty about Overpass. CTs are not supposed to stay in the A side, they're supposed to spread out to balloons, they're supposed to take over the connector area, the long area, while at the same time the conflict happens when the CTs are supposed to actually stick into B side. They're supposed to be defensive on B side, offensive on A side. This is how Overpass works. Unless you're getting overpowered, you get overflashed, you get oversmoked or whatever, then you go back to the side. Here we have a Nico's probably having a 20% loss. Is this what he's saying?
Ow. And it looks like we're ready to go. All you guys watching, hope you guys are enjoying this. It's a really nice experience for Ice and I, and we'd like to thank AG for giving us this.
Don't forget to subscribe, please.
Or subscribing is important if you want to see more of this. And it looks like we're ready to go. 5-1 lead. From your experience, Ice, I think this is an equally balanced map, as I was talking earlier.
In my opinion, in my honest opinion, due to my experience, I think it can be more of a T-sided map because you get to push aside as 5 people with smokes and nades and flashes, while only 2 or 3 people are holding.
Like C5 is doing right now, just they are trying to take control of that mid area. I mean, the mid area and overpass is just not too important to take control of. I mean, you still can go from through that toilet and connect.
Here's a smart play by Spy. He's actually jumping up on short, a really quick peek to see if there's anybody at short borders or not. When doing that and getting the info that there's nobody at this area. Careful on A side.
Look at that lineup that C5 has right now. They have one player on every position. While Ground Zero, they have two. And just soon, if they lose this round, they're gonna reset their economy and they're gonna have to either force buy or just go full eco.
Absolutely.
Not to mention they are going slowly towards that A side in a really smart way, and Blue is just waiting here.
Getting all the info he wants from Spy.
Flashes towards that A side, it's gonna be the unbelievable Rookie and Virus on Nico on that side. Waiting patiently for that A push, a nice boost there. They're gonna abuse it, and Virus is gonna pay the price. Nico with a kill, he's gonna go for the second shot. Nice play by Blue, and Blue with another kill, and Blue is gonna go down. Fools with another headshot as well. It's a 1v2 situation now. Here it is. The Clutch Master is about to do some really good job with that AWP. Rookie from that connector is gonna get spotted here. His position is gonna get revealed, and we're gonna see Rookie here. Just getting headshotted immediately. Really nice round by
CT. By seeing it, like, the CTs knew that T-sides were going to be at A-side, but then they smoked long off. Okay, that's fine, but you don't really have long control. Then the Virus just does this random peek after the smoke. There's 3 guys there, you got instant killed, so that's a bit stupid. You don't want to do these things. You're playing on the main game. This is the third game. Every second, every thing you do matters.
We're gonna see Fools here taking control towards that underpath area, and I mean the economy of Ground Zero just got damaged right now, so this is an important round for them to win. And the T's aren't just getting back on their feet. One more time, Natar with a really nice boost is gonna be able to take down Nico real quickly, and the aggressiveness is not just working anymore for Ground Zero, so they have to maybe find another solution. Play safe for a couple of rounds, because C5, they are really good at reading Ground Zero right now. Blue is going to play aggressively towards that toilet area. Meanwhile, the bomb is on the other side of the map. As you can see, only one guy stands towards that B side, and we have 2 players on A. The rotation is just going to take a lot
nice
of time.
Play being set, prepared by C5 for B side.
At how fast and how quickly they're gonna move. The Molotovs are getting in, the rotations are coming. 2 guys on B side already, and we're gonna see it right now. It's do or die. Look at the smokes, how perfect this looks. And Rookie is gonna try to deny the bomb plant. It's not gonna actually work, but it's gonna hit him down to 50 HP only. And the retake is possible, but it's gonna be so tough and so hard for Ground Zero here. And look at Blue. Nice kill there by Blue with the M4A1 in hand. He's gonna try to defuse, try to shake some nerves here. Blue shooting in the smoke. They are surrounded. Fools is gonna get a kill. Rookie is gonna get a kill as well. And Blue with another kill. Blue with a third. Unbelievable. Blue almost clutches this, but it's down to 6 HP only. It was a really nice retake from GZ, but C5 just did solidly and beautifully there.
Yes, C5 are playing it safe, man. They really want to win this. I mean, they planted the bomb as 5 and they all rotated back. Nobody stayed in the side to die from I don't know where. This is how you are supposed to play on B side. You're supposed to plant and then disappear and just wait. Hold properly. This is what they did. This is why they won the round. They were better. I mean, Ground Zero, they had 2 guys on B side, but then they were not actually holding anywhere. They couldn't get any entry frag, they couldn't get a first kill or anything. The T side were more comfortable in getting the sides than actually, you know, having any problems to actually rush it.
Now we're gonna see some more aggressiveness here from Rookie. He's been doing a really good job with the aggressive plays with Nico as well. some really huge focus to west that A long area spy with that deagle that could be deadly. Maybe use Ricky as a bait and look. Here it is. This shot to send is all. The crossfire is gonna work. Virus is gonna get the third. Unbelievably done there. Down to a 3v4 situation here, ladies and gentlemen. Virus is gonna get mollied really quickly, and the flank is about to begin. What they don't know is that the bomb is rotating quickly towards Nico without him knowing. He thinks that they're on A long, but actually they're not. And a really smart move there by Hamad. A is gonna spot Nico down, and Rookie is gonna get down to 40 HP here. But they have managed actually to do something about this. I mean, even if GZ they lost this round, they've done enough damage in my personal opinion.
Yeah, they actually like managed to throw away full of AKs, and their C5's economy isn't really that great right now. So yeah, any weapon they could lose is actually effective.
Look at this, 14 HP Nico with a deagle. Can he manage to get a one ding? Or is he gonna fall down really quickly? Ah, that was a nice shot by Nico, but it's not gonna work. The Molly is already on that truck. They are waiting for Blue to rotate, and he has full HP with a deagle in hand. 30 seconds on the clock. It's gonna be enough. And look at this. They're trying to do something. Smoking off that CT area. And Kuf just waiting for Blue to do one mistake before he gets one tapped. Blue is just waiting. Nice shot by Blue there. And it's gonna be a 1v2 all of a sudden. Blue must look for another kill just to damage some more economy for team 5 here. Fools is just waiting for Blue, and Blue tries to go for the second peek, and it's not gonna work. Nice comeback so far by C5 from 5-0 to 5-4.
That's the consistency I've been talking about. I mean, C5 is a very good team. They know what they're doing, they know what they're supposed to do, they know the potentials. They don't try anything crazy, anything stupid, you know, no rushes, no something abnormal. They know what they're doing, they know the map, they know how it works, and they want to win, badly.
And look at C5 now, just spreading all over the area, and we're going to see a really nice strategic boost here from Ground Zero. We're just going to be able to spot C5 before they actually come to them, and a really nice aggressive play by Virus is going to get the first with that headshot. And Virus is just have full control of the B site, completely of that monster area and short area and the connector. He's going to give a lot of information to Ground Zero right now, just because of that aggression play, but he's gonna go down immediately from Natal. A really nice refrag here. And there it is. Back to a 2v2 setup. Two guys on B and two guys on A, and that's how you play the game. But another amazing boost by Ground Zero. One more time, they're just using everything so painful. This 5 might be walking into a trap, because Blue is waiting there towards that corner. He's gonna get shotted by Hamad, and the rotations, they are beginning. Nice pop flash here. Spy is going to be able to get him down, and it's a 2v2. This is an important round for both teams, actually. It's going to be Rookie and Nico on Hamad and Natal, ladies and gentlemen. And the smoke towards that short area is there. Nice headshot by Kuf. He is going to be able to take down Nico so quickly. But don't forget, Rookie is actually really good at clutching situations like this. Pop flash from his own teammate might be a mistake, but it's not going to affect anything. The information that Rookie is on that heaven is going to be given. Nice use of the utilities, nice patience, and there's a Molly that's just ready for that site. Now just waiting, dancing on that statue right here, and it's going to be awesome. Nice headshot. 5-5, almost. Miscommunication by Team Ground Zero. Rookie, Spy and Blue, they just wasn't ready for that B push.
Absolutely, absolutely. C5 stepping up again. This is a level of Counter-Strike we're looking at. Now Ground Zero are in their code. C5's economy, if they win this round, is going to be amazing. They're going to be consistent for at least two other rounds.
Alright then, it's a 5v5 and a nice shot by Rookie. A one-ding actually, really quickly. These aggressive plays, sometimes when they work, they're actually very beneficial to you. And Nico just got too greedy for the AK, and he pays the price. And that's a mistake that you tried to tell your previous team about. They wouldn't learn from it. When you see a weapon, you just don't go simply and go grab it, because of course there's someone going to be waiting for you there.
Absolutely. I mean, it's the perfect thing to bait somebody with.
The aggressive play by Virus. Not going to work. Virus tries to aggressive, it's not gonna work. Spy just waiting on the other side. Latal going for really nice one taps. Meanwhile, Blue is gonna kill Hamad on that A site here. And look at this spy in a really deadly position. He's gonna give Ground Zero all the info he needs, and Spy gets the first with that 5-7. He's gonna go try for the second. It's not gonna work. Blue with the AK in hand and charging towards that A side. Blue gets the first. He's gonna try to go for that second, and it's a 1v1 situation. There's no kit on Blue whatsoever. So if he wins this round, build some momentum up, going for their one taps. Blue in a really nice position, and nice round there by Natal. He's just one-tapping everything that's standing in his way.
Natal actually had a very, very good position to stay in. He knew how to hold his position properly against Blue. I mean, he knew where he was, he knew his angles properly. He managed to just use the ducks to his advantage, and Blue was just hopeless. He didn't have armor, he couldn't do anything.
We're gonna see another double AWP setup here. It was working really good for Ground Zero. Maybe they can try it again. Nico is gonna go for that aggressive push, and a really nice flick shot, Nico. Inhuman flick shot there by Nico.
One, yeah.
I couldn't believe my eyes for a second. And the aggression here, eyes should stop. Like, okay, you got a frag, you just play safe now. You are one man ahead. Always better for you. We're gonna see the mid control here towards that toilets from Cool. And we're going to see another aggression from Rookie as well in that connector. And he's not going to be able, missing a couple of shots, and it could be really crucial here. Another aggression from Virus, he's going to pay the price for it. And the rotations are ready to begin. Now C5 can decide to either go B from that connector or just charge that A site from the toilets. And look at Nego, he's just probably lost right now. He doesn't know what to do. So this is a really good position and a good spot to stay in most of the time. Hearing a couple of flashes towards that B site, and Nico is just waiting patiently. Y and Blue is just waiting as well on that B site. Bomb, it's me. Towards that A long area. And look at that A split ice. Look how amazing that A split is. Two people from short and two people from long.
Clearly, you get all the map control you need.
You have utilities in their hands, they got a couple of mollies, a couple of flashes. And that's all they need actually to get this round. Spy is just waiting and ready. Nice flash, molly towards that T bank here. And we're gonna see Spy, it's all on you. Sprays with an M4, gets the first flick, shots the second. Spy, are you kidding me? That spray control gets him 3 frags. Just 8 seconds left on the round, and there's nothing Force can do about it because Nico is here. You needed a miracle, and a miracle is what you got.
What the hell was that, Spy? What the fuck? Nobody can spray like that. What? What? No. You need to call a timeout or something. You need to do something with this guy. This guy is on fire.
Look at Spy right now. 15 frags, topping the whole scoreboard here. And Spy, I bet you that Spy is gonna wreck right now after that round in particular. Like, he's gonna get so much confidence. And look at this, Spy with a first, going for the second one. Spy is gonna be able to get it. Another one, and then a fourth. My Spy. What is going on here? Just headshots everywhere by the M4A4. It is deadly in the hands of the wrong guy.
I'm speechless. I'm actually enjoying this, you know?
You gotta help me with the talking, because I'm speechless as well.
This is single-handedly just killed four of the guys.
Previously,
single-handedly stopped the freaking rush around before killing three guys in one spray.
This
who
is what
is this guy? Who is this god spy?
This is what GZ needed on C5. I think they should go for a tactical timeout, probably figure some things out. We are having some issues. 5 just spreading one more time on that map. There's a connector battle here between Nico and probably Cool is on the other side of the map, just chilling, waiting for an aggression play here. Why is gonna actually manage to get the kill. Nico almost though with that flick shot, but he's gonna pay for it. You miss, you die. And right now, something happened. Blue got kicked out of the back band. That back band?
I don't know what. For some reason, Blue got kicked out or something.
Back! Oh, he needs to reset his.
Well, I guess. I don't think D5 have any intentions to actually stopping. They want to win this round. But they took this round.
Let's see what the admin is gonna decide here. Meanwhile, Virus is playing really solid towards that retake. And he's going slowly towards that B side. Two people just waiting for him. Virus is gonna go for that clutch almost, but he's gonna die from Oliver. So, Ice, it looks like we are finally good to go.
Yes, we're live again. 7-6 to ground zero. Final game. Best of three quarterfinals. See what we're gonna do.
Now we're gonna see Blue here heading towards that B side, the guy who actually disconnected. Meanwhile, C5, they are going to take control of that mid area. Spy is gonna throw down a molly here. Some really nice flanks from the T's. And look at Fools, he's already on that B side and he's gonna die immediately and pay for it. Nico with the AWP hit there. The B side push is just amazing. Spy with another kill. Spy with a third. Spy is unbelievable right now. It's a 1v4 situation. All of a sudden there, Nico is the last guy here. Tatal is the last guy standing. Virus is gonna molly him off. I mean, they have the bomb, and it's a 1v3 situation. And he's only down to 7 HP. There's nothing you can do about that right now.
So Lex, the C5 is actually calling for a pause. Maybe they wanna do... Maybe they wanna do a tactical one? I don't know. Just while saving his AK with 7 HP. Got lucky out of that.
Who is gonna... He's actually gonna miss a couple of PvP shots here. He's only down to 7 HP and he's gonna die. It's gonna be 8-6 for ground zero here. I'm still pretty lost and confused about what's going on.
Dude, they're calling for a pause, they're calling for a non-pause. I mean... Alright, I guess so. So, C5 are actually going to force this out. This is the last round of the first half. Ground Zero looks like their economy is fully loaded with all the nades and stuff. They got Tech-9s and T-sizes and 2 UMP on Fools and Alvar. And looks like they're playing on A.
With the Tech-9s and a UMP, it's not really smart to play on A, but we're gonna see an A push really quickly here from Latal. Nico is gonna get the first, going for the second kill. Nice round by Nico. He's trying to go for the third, but Rookie has his back from that toilets area. Nice AWP combo wombo there. Rookie is gonna miss a shot, but guess what? Nico is just on the other side of the corner, just waiting for Cyrex to push, and he's gonna die from Virus. A 9-6 there.
Yeah, a nice op combination. It's like, you know, tag and take, or whatever, whatever you want to call it. It was a nice play, it was a nice play. Like, two ops, we're both covering both angles. It was a really nice play.
It was a really nice comeback from the bottom, from ground zero, honestly, but still, nothing changed yet. They still can lose this round. It's all about that pistol, and we're going to see some aggression towards that mid area. Basically, they go connector. They might flank out from B one more time, and we're gonna see Latal with that USB in hand, just waiting for one head to show so he can get that kill. And there it is, the one tap onto Blue that I was talking about earlier. The Glocks, they are rushing towards that A site, ladies and gentlemen. And look at the CT, is a nice shot by Virus. He's gonna go for the second one, but Spy, he has Zen. He wants to go for that USPS. He might pay for it, but no, Spy has something else to say. It's a 3v4 situation here. Nice protection there for the bomb planter, and it's gonna be able to take Virus down. Spy with another kill there with the USPS, and it's a 2v3 situation all of a sudden. They have an info, and look at that push from Kuf going in with that P2000. Just 1v1, that's all that's left. Kuf against Rookie, a P2000 against one P2000, and there's a kit in the toilets here. Nice clutch there by Kuf. It's gonna be astonishing, really. Ground Zero loses this round. Very wisely there from C5.
I mean, Kuf really had it good. I mean, he actually got the bomb, he actually killed three guys and pick up a kid and actually bomb. Really nice round by Kuf.
He was just so patient there, just waiting for Rookie to make a mistake, and Rookie was baited out really easily. Hiding in an area where he shouldn't be hiding. And that's the price you get when you don't know how to handle a 1v1 situation. Since the bomb has been planted, we're not going to see any force buy here from Team Ground Zero. Instead, they're going to rush towards that B area from short really quickly here. And Oliver is going to get ready for some action. Double kill, nice spray control here. And it's going to be support and a team wipe real quickly there from Team C5. A very nicely handed round there. Now G0, they are fully ready, committed for that full buy, 5 AKs with the utilities in hand. The decoys are just an amazing way to decoy your enemy out, to trick them, throw some decoys here and there. But look at the weak buy here from Team C5, they got 2 UMPs and a FAMAS, and it might not be good, especially with this aggression that's going on here from Oliver. They are trying to go for something, and look at that crossfire eyes over here. Was that connector area.
They did a really good aggressive play here. They actually had short control. And Ground Zero is going to expect that. With those smokes.
You're going to see a shift walk here towards that monster. And I think that C5 already know what's going on here. They're going to try to push Ground Zero. Nico going in first. Virus one more time. He spots out someone that is going to get headshotted really quickly. Two people on the shore, they're not going to realize that. And look at Cool in a really smart position. He's going to die quickly. Nico is going to die as well. Kup, it's all on you. He's going to get Molotov. Then it's all on Blue, the last guy standing here. It's going to be a 9-9 round probably, unless Blue, of course, pulls out a miracle. Nice headshot there by Blue. He's on that short area, just waiting for one more to peek. 85 HP, he has a couple of nades to work with, a flash and a decoy. He could actually trick the enemy, but I don't see Blue doing anything in this round. And he's going slowly towards that B monster here, just waiting patiently for someone to do a mistake. And it's not gonna work. Here's C5, they are fully committed to that B side, protecting the bomb from Blue. They hear Blue actually reloading here. Blue is gonna get the second kill, and he's gonna die eventually. Nice try. And it's down to 9-9. Very funny how one round can actually...
Absolutely. I mean, also C5, they've proven themselves to have a very consistent side map. Know the roles, they know... I mean, the fact they actually went to shorts, they took short control, they got almost like... They had the advantage here. So Ground Zero did not know that, because they had nobody in connect and nobody actually tried to go into shorts. If they knew that they already had short control and there were three guys in B-side, they wouldn't have...
We have three smokes here on Ground Zero. Do you think we're gonna see something special here, maybe? Just a bomb plant try?
I think they're gonna do... They're gonna try to get a plant at least. This is when they're gonna troop, because they didn't force. They got semi-armor, three smokes just enough to get into a site and plant in the smoke, maybe. That's their goal out of this round, but they're playing really low. I'm in camping, probably is have something in mind there.
I'm gonna see C5 also here be patient, just holding every angle. We're gonna see Latal right now aiming for that peak, waiting for someone to just show his head for 1 second. Bam, it's a one tap. Very easy for Latal actually, and we're gonna see stations here from Ground Zero. Two guys just waiting on that B monster, and the rest, they got smokes in hand. Rookie gives really nice information there about Hamad, who is hiding actually. He's gonna be able to take down Rookie and Virus as well. Nice double kill by Hamad, and look at this one-way smoke here. It's gonna be really amazing for Fools to pull that off, and the bomb is on the other side of the map. Spy is just searching for everyone. Nice headshot by Spy here, but he's gonna get down from Natal. He has an AK in hand. They just want that bomb plant. They want nothing else. They just need that bomb plant, and that's what they're gonna get. It's down to a 2v3 situation and a 1v3 situation, and Blue is gonna go down. At least they got the bomb plant. It's gonna boost their economy maybe a little bit. Oliver was trying to flank as well.
Well, I guess they tried. This is what they wanted. They wanted to plant a bomb on the sites, and that's what they did. Had a goal and they fulfilled that goal. Now this is the most important round. I mean, Ground Zero should actually focus on winning this round. Otherwise, they're gonna be in trouble.
Not gonna do a lot of damage though. some aggression towards that B site here from ground zero. Blue is going to be able to take down Cool. Meanwhile, Virus is dead. And look at that short control going in really slowly here towards that short area, making sure to make C5 just stuck in one place, but that's not going to happen because there are two people on A side just waiting for that connector flank to happen. We're going to see 4v4 situation there by ground zero, just putting together some info. And look at that one tap of Spy from that boost. He's going to smoke it in, pop flashing in, and God Spy is just charging towards that B side. He's getting shot at from that ABC area, and he's gonna give his team his info. It's a 3v3, just a crucial round for both teams. And look at Nico just getting the first really nicely there. They have the information about the have ABC, and they have a nice Molotov by Rookie, and he's gonna burn him down. It's all on Latal, ladies and gentlemen. He's already charging towards that A side, and he's gonna get a double spray. What is happening? It's all on Rookie one more time. It's a 1v1 situation, ladies and gentlemen, and Latal is gonna play really aggressive here, trying to convince Rookie to bait him, but it's not gonna work. Almost one mistake costed ground zero the game and not just the round.
Absolutely, I mean, that double kill he actually got, okay, I gotta admit, the guy did a really nice play, but then the guys of ground zero, the T-sided guys, ground zero guys, what the hell are you doing? I mean, you can't really just, you know, you need to spread out. This is how you make a CD guy confused, you spread out. But it was a nice try, actually.
We're gonna see Oliver here with the aggression on the AWP play, but he's gonna get flashed really nicely here. Nice boost going on here from Ground Zero, and 10-10, I'm really impressed in this game. It's so long and it's so good, full of potential, full of tactics. You know, both teams are playing patiently here, just waiting for something to happen right now. A minute and a half almost gone that round, and we're gonna see Blue going in towards that connector area, and he's gonna get paid for it, down to 21 HP only. He saw it coming, actually, because he was crouching there, and unfortunately did not get the shot, and he did not get killed either. So it's still a 5v5 here going on. Look at the GZ making their way towards that toilets. You're gonna see Blue as well. I think Blue should be refragging at this phase because he has like 20 HP, and the rotations are about to begin from C5, and it might be too late, but two people are already rotating from B side. And look at this. See, this is what you were talking about. They have four people on A and the bomb is already going towards that B side. And this is just fantastic. If GZ, they are able to pull this off, it's gonna be amazing. But look who's waiting. Fools is there. He's gonna get the first with the farmers. Gets the second and the third. Amazingly solid defense from Fool. The Ground Zero had the round. They went and played it perfectly, and it's all on Spy. He has the AK now, and he's gonna die real quickly. Everything
that was amazing. Cool. I mean, yeah, they did it right. I told you, this is how fast faking can be in Overpass. They did everything right by the book. Beautiful. They just failed so hard, you know? Fools just was taking them one by one. One by one, he's standing there with the Famas. I mean, well played, Fools. Really nice hold. The strat was nice, but the actual execution was not.
We're gonna see some mid aggression here from Team Ground Zero. Nico with the Tech 9 is gonna lead the charge here, and look at the Kuf just waiting for one mistake, trying to re-smoke that short area on the B site. And we're gonna see Nico and Rookie here just making their way towards that A long. Meanwhile, we're gonna see hiding. We're gonna try that boost on that A long, just waiting for someone. Virus tries to go for that peek towards that Deagle, but it's not gonna work. He's gonna miss a couple of shots. Falls down to 71 HP, and the rotations are about to begin. Balls with their UMP in hand. He's gonna spot a lot of players here. There's no rotation whatsoever from Team C5, and this is what's driving me crazy, because they don't over-rotate. They just play so patiently and so sweet. The whole GZ team is on that A side. Nice one shot by Rookie with that Deagle. Another shot followed up by Faris, but the bomb is on that toilets, and Kuf has enough time. But look at the T's. They already have AKs in hand, and nice shot there by Ahmad. Spy is gonna get the third, and look at this. Spike tries to go for the one tap, and he's gonna get naded down, and it's gonna be enough to kill him. It's a 2v2 situation. Rookie and Virus with just a Deagle and a UMP in hand. 25 seconds on the clock. Look at this, they might get the bait. He's gonna spot them out. And he has the bomb, he's running towards that A site really quickly, just 15 more seconds to go. And they are chasing them on the chase. The bomb is going to get dropped, and the incendiary is just going to use wisely there. And it's almost impossible for Fires to win this round, just 3 more seconds to go. Really, really, really nice comeback there by C5.
Absolutely, like I said, they need this win. I mean, they played really nice the first map, the second map, Ground Zero proved themselves to be better. And now here, this is the real fight. This is most probably the most exciting game I've, well, obviously there's more games to see, but for now, this is the most exciting game I've ever seen.
Exactly, we're gonna see what an AK here for us on Taruki. Maybe they have something planned ahead. It's gonna be a disaster for Team Ground Zero if they still go like that. Their plays are just so smart, but they're not applying the execution, as you said. And look at this, Griffiths is gonna be able to rumble them down. Meanwhile, Rookie gets one kill towards Cyrix here. And nice headshot by Rookie again. It's a 2v3, and Nico with just a Glock in hand. Pretty much useless. Maybe they can go and try for that bomb plant, but guess what? Goof is waiting for them. Rookie is gonna go down, and Nico is gonna follow him anytime soon. 13-10 for Team C5. Very impressive comeback here.
That doesn't look very comforting for Ground Zero. I mean, C5, yes, they're consistent. They are playing good enough to actually own this game. It's like single road. They're painting. You know what I mean? It's like painting, or it's like just like driving. I know what I want. This is what I want. I want it now. I'm gonna win it. So I'm gonna work for it. I'm gonna play hard for it. That's what C5 is all about. It's about the commitment, the team play, the strong will they have to actually win the game. As you may see, look, also the scoreboard. I mean, okay, you got Cuff and you got Latal also top fragging both of the teams. Cool. Even though he's the most bottom fragger of the game, he's still playing as support. Fools did a really nice hold. I mean, if that round Ground Zero actually had it, the game might have flipped. But Fools actually managed to stop it, just like Spy actually managed to stop before. It's like an eye for an eye. This is what this game is all about, and it's amazing. It's tense.
That's
the third map. The winner here goes to the main event, to main qualifier event. So,
are we going to see a deja vu that we saw earlier, that last pause where Ground Zero just came back hardly in that game? I mean, this is a deadly round for both teams. If C5 managed to win this round, pretty much over for Ground Zero.
I mean, look at that Ground Zero. Like, Ground Zero, you got Spy. You got Spy with 27 bombs. And then Rookie's following him with 19. And then Virus, I don't know what's Virus's problem right now. Probably because he's being an in-game leader, he's probably calling out a lot of strats, so he's not focusing on the aim, just like Cool, maybe Cool, doing the same. But they need to step up. This is the moment we realize it's either now or never.
And now we're gonna see some aggression here from Ground Zero towards that B side. Just two going in from the connector. And look at the aggression as well from the A people there from C5. They have all the information they need and they are ready to flank. And look at them going, Ground Zero. It might be a trap, it might be a bait there. Waiting for C5 to do one mistake and they're already on short. But the sad part is they have a flanker just coming from T spawn and they don't know that yet. If anything happens, just one mistake, it's going to be GG for Team C5 here. The bomb carrier should always be patient. Nico has everything in mind, and look at this. Nico is going to get ready, and there it is, the mistake that he's been waiting for. He notices it, but it's not going to be enough to take him out. And Spy is going to get a second frag here. 3v3 situation. Rookie with a really smart choice of flanking. He's going to get spotted. Nice shot by Rookie. This is what they needed to come back in this game. It's a 3v2 already. The rotations are happening. The guys on A are still on A. Only one guy on B. And guess who's on B? It's going to be Fools in that really sick position that killed out 3 people. And it's all on Latal, ladies and gentlemen. He has an AK in hand, on the barrels, he's gonna get the first, gets the second, it's not gonna work, and Fools is on that spot, dancing behind that statue. Virus, he has the bomb in his hand, and he's going for that one tap, and Virus is gonna be able to do it. 13-11 for Team Ground Zero.
I mean, that round was supposed to be all for C5, they had all the info they needed, they had the map control they needed. I don't know what went wrong over there. I mean, okay, the guy pushed from CT. Nico did something very stupid. You know that somebody's here. You know he's not a teammate. Don't peek before him. Let them pass. No? It's an easy kill, but I guess, like, good job, Ground Zero. They actually managed to pull out the round.
You're gonna see some really aggressive flashes here towards that B site one more time, and it looks like somebody is already on B, and Nico is just waiting. Look at the T's, how good they are communicating with each other. Nico with just a Tech 9 in hand, down to 43 HP, and Blue as well. They are just getting wall banged really, really nicely there. And look at that lineup that Ground Zero has right now. They know the boost. And nice wall bank by Blue. He's gonna manage to take him down really quickly. Cool with a farmers in hand, and the B execution is gonna start. The rotations are happening. Blue is just waiting to open up things. He's gonna spot someone in the ABC, and nice shot by Virus. And Blue, cool, is still in that water area. And Blue with a third kill. Blue is back on track. The guy who disconnected just wins another round for Ground Zero. This is amazing. It's all on Lethal, ladies and gentlemen, and it looks like Lethal has no other option but to save, and Ground Zero Virus is just waiting for him to do that flank.
I mean, it all started with that silly kill of a wall bang. I mean, who actually gets a kill like that? It's so rare to actually kill somebody with a wall bang over there. I mean, if you get boosted or something, okay, that's one thing, but then just doing a full wallbang spray and actually managed to get the kill, that was the entry kill through the wall without actually having any eye contact with the enemy. That was nice. Blue actually stepped up and managed to wrap up the round for Ground Zero.
Indeed, Ice. Let's see if C5 are gonna force this round. Sorry, I mean, they have an M4. It would be really hard for them if they force by this round. It's gonna be crucial, and that's exactly what they're not gonna do. They're gonna manage that M4 to take it on that B site since the focus is there. But look at Ground Zero now. They're not gonna focus on B anymore. They're just gonna spread out the whole entire map. They're gonna wait for somebody to push, and that's what C5 are doing right now. Already one guy on the tree. Nice crossfire there from the toilets, and the rest people are doing a triple boost, as I can see here on that minimap. Something phenomenal, really. We're just gonna wait for Ground Zero. Look at them. They know that the enemies are on eco. They got 5 AKs, full utilities to work with, and they're just waiting for a mistake. And there it is, the mistake that's gonna happen. It's gonna be Lethal here trying to go for a double kill. It's not gonna work, and now it's a 4v4.
And they just lost the most lethal weapon the C5 had. They lost the M4.
Look at that triple boost that's happening, right? Amazing.
I really love the boost. Not a lot of people actually expect it.
Look at this. The Virtus Pro tactic where you smoke everything on B and you just simply might just go A with that bomb, but it looks like they're gonna get committed to it, that B site. But cool is waiting. That P250 could be really, really deadly, and the flashes they are in. Cool. They're just waiting for someone. Look, this is so beautiful. Ah, he stepped down by mistake, and this might have cost him the round here, but there are 4 people already onto B-side. Spy is gonna spray it first. Virus going in for the second towards that river, and he's trying to shoot his teammate. It's not gonna work. Fools is gonna go down, and it's gonna be 13-13 for G0.
I'm looking at the pause here. Is there gonna be a pause? One. What a shame. Well, I guess they already planned out what C5 wanted to do this round, and well, cool needs to step up if his team wants to win. I mean, it's only Cuff and Lethal actually playing, and then meanwhile Rookie Blue and Spy's already on 30 bomb.
I mean, this is a very, very important round for C5 here. I mean, look at their economy.
Things, actually.
They have nothing. I mean, Ground Zero can still manage to buy next round with utilities, but look at the economy of C5, for example. They don't have anything. This is do or die for them. This round is very good, and hoping they're going to win this round, it's going to change a lot of things in the pace. You're going to see Blue here towards that connector, trying to shoulder peek, and it's going to work really nicely. We got 3 players here from C5 on that B site, and 2 players on A. You're going to see some really nice flashes and utility.
And like, look, they're doing the same thing again when they took the short control, but this time they couldn't because Ground Zero had people at a connector, which is successful.
Rotation from A towards B is gonna start now, and this might be crucial right there. If G0 are committed to that B site take, get Cool's position. It's a really nice position. He's gonna be able to get down the third. Cool is gonna die, and look at this, Cyrex just from behind destroying every single one of them.
That was a poor play by Ground Zero. I mean, you already showed your presence that you were at B site. You should not commit to a B site. You've done that, okay, one time, two times, three times. This is what I'm talking about. You gotta change the pace. You gotta do something unexpected, unpredictable. Don't be silly, don't be, you know, predictable.
That position was really deadly from Fools there. And we're gonna see the first RPRs D side from Nico might answer a lot of questions here. I mean, Ground Zero knows the whole pressure is on B, so why not switch to A, switch in pace? They're still committing for that B site, and it looks like they're gonna try to get control of that playground here. Nico is just waiting for one aggression from C5. Just when you're very sure that your enemy is very aggressive, they just start playing passive. That's where the nerves start to begin.
Yeah, these are all mind games. It's mind games right now. Half of this rounds is just mind games. It's not actually playing.
You're gonna see some nades here going on to West side B side, and Virus with a fake. He's gonna get down really quickly. The rotations are not even doing anything here. Look at the A long. They hear them, they know that they are A, and he is on your right. He is gonna be able to kill Blue there. Nice shot by Latal, nice shot by Spy and Rookie. Spy with another one tap here, 3v2 out of nowhere. Is this game ever gonna end, guys? And we're gonna see the retake that's gonna happen right now. Koof, he has an AK in hand. He decides to stick with the M4. Nice nade towards that bomb planter. Rookie down to 36 HP. Nico with that AWP, it's going to be a very strong position. Unfortunately, nobody is rotating, actually, and a really nice round taken by Ground Zero.
This is so... Wow, this game is really, really intense. One round and run round, everyone's doing his part. I mean, the round before, you got Koff actually killing people, and now you got Spy actually in return. It's an eye for an eye, James. It's an eye for an eye.
Latal and, Koff and Spy, they are just... They want to know who's the best here, you know?
Absolutely.
And look at this smart decision here from C5. They decided not to buy anything. Latal is trying to go for that one ding in the deagle. Virus missing a really easy shot there, but finally he's gonna get the kill on Fools. It's a 5v4 situation, and we might see an overtime because C5 have a lot of money to work with next round, and you never know what happens. But still, the round is not over yet. Look at Latal in a really dangerous position. Blue is going to be able to take him down really quickly there. And the bomb is already rotating towards that B site. Mind games, wherever you go. And we're going to see Rookie here trying not to make steps. The bomb is going towards that B site really shortly. And look at the patience just paying Virus with an opening kill towards that B site. Spy is going to be able to handle him as well. The bomb is going to get planted here. And it's all on Cyrex. Oliver, actually. Getting molded, getting smoked, getting whatever. You can imagine a Nico just reads it like a book. Look at this. It's going to be 15-14.
This is a round.
If G0 come back,
I bet you $100. It's gonna go for Ground Zero.
I'll bet you $200. It's gonna go for C5.
$200. Let's go.
$200 on C5, $100 on Ground Zero. This is the most important round. I would love to get $200 for free. We're gonna see what's gonna happen right here. The aggression is gonna begin, and look at that. G0, they learned from their mistakes. They're just playing passively right now, waiting for somebody to push, waiting for some aggression. They were losing 13-10, and now it's 15-14 for Ground Zero, and this is really, really impressive. C5, they might have some confidence issues. Ice is just begging for that $200 that he wants. He's so nervous, waiting for the round to start, actually. Nice spot flash there from C5. Just waiting for one mistake that Ground Zero is about to do. It's the round 30. This is the third map that actually goes to round 30, actually.
I'm actually praying here, Dams. You know, I'm not a prayer. I'm not a religious person. Here I am, praying right now.
And we're gonna see Rookie. The timing is really bad here. Two players on A, meanwhile three to that B side, trying to do some boosts. Rookie giving all the information needed, and look at the rotations. Three people already on that A site. Fools is just waiting with that FAMAS already. And there it is, the execution towards that A site, going all the way from long, and the bomb is coming from the toilets. Fools is gonna get the first with the farmers, and Rookie is gonna go with a B site. That plan just worked so perfectly. Three people on A and just two on the B side. All Ground Zero has to do is kill these two guys with the rotations. They are coming down really quickly here. Rookie is gonna go for that one tap. It's not gonna work. The UMP is gonna do the play. Nice shot by Spy. Double kill by Spy, and Rookie is gonna go 1v1 straight ahead with Fools. Fools is on the other side of the map right now, and this is so dangerous for Rookie. 5 seconds on the clock. He's gonna have to plant the bomb. And in such situations, it'd be so hard for Luki to clutch this, but I'm a believer and I want $100 at Ground Zero! They gonna clutch this round from 13-10 to 16.